here at the ARM booth here. And who are you?
I'm Ben. I'm one of the co-founders of Jide Technologies. We are a startup based in Beijing.
And you make this awesome Remix OS.
Yes.
So let's bring it right here. This is, what is this device?
It's a device which we partner with AOC to build. It's an all-in-one device. It's basically a monitor, but we have an AmLogic S905 PCB running in it. So that's why.
So that's a super smooth Remix OS on a quad core ARM Cortex-A53, multi window.
Yep.
And AOC is making a beautiful monitor right here. AOC is a big player in the monitor business, right?
Correct. So we are combining the expertise in the monitor space. You can see that it is very thin and it has a full HD, very sharp colors.
And so AOC, did you go to them or they went to you?
They actually reached out to us.
Reach out to you and you say, hey, let's do it. And they seem to be happy so far. How soon is it launching?
It's actually launching in 2 weeks. Already announced this in CES Asia in Shanghai. And we are going to, they are already in formal production. So we are going to formally launch it in 2 weeks and then it will go on sale in China.
Can we look on the side behind? So there's a PCB right here with the S905.
Correct. It's inside. Yep.
And right here?
Right there. Here, yes.
And all the ports is 4 USB?
4 USB, we have a LAN, you can plug in an Ethernet cable.
Gigabit Ethernet.
There's HDMI, but this one is actually for the monitor.
So you can use HDMI in, yes.
So you can use this as a monitor, or you can use it as a all-in-one. So if you use this as a monitor, you just plug HDMI in, and then it will become a monitor for any external
device. Windows, whatever people want,
correct.
Or another Remix Mini.
Yes, okay, yes.
And then you have audio in and out?
Yes, this is audio in.
So I mean, the business model should be, I guess, that for the monitor, the maker, there's not that much big of a increase in cost to add Remix,
correct,
right?
Correct. Adding an ARM-based board, it doesn't suck up much power, and it also, the cost is relatively cheap. But you can turn a monitor into an all-in-one, and you can do all the work on here. You can play games, you can play videos, you can use all the Android apps here. So it becomes a very useful standalone device, which you can put it in your living room or put it in your office.
How do you switch between the HDMI input and the Remix?
It's automatic.
Automatic. So if there's an HDMI input, it goes there.
Yeah. Or you can use the manual monitor switches here to do the switching.
To go on HDMI or not. This is a button right here.
Yeah. There are some buttons. It's actually you can use it as a regular monitor. Yeah. You can adjust the color. You can adjust the saturation, and also you can adjust.
Does it have sound?
Yes. It has speakers built in.
That's beautiful. There's two sizes, right?
Yes. It will come in 24 inch and 32 inch.
So do you use Remix OS as your only OS for your personal use?
Yes.
You do?
Most of our employees, except those developers who need to do coding, are using Remix OS devices.
They code on Remix OS?
Theoretically, you can.
You can?
Yeah, you can. Yeah.
Because do you force all your employees to use Remix all the time?
Yeah, we force most of the employees, like non-technical employees at least, to use Remix OS all the time.
Because then they would know what to fix to make it like totally usable,
correct.
Right?
We believe that dog food is essential in order to build a good product.
And do you force all the Google employees to use Remix? I mean, why didn't Android N show this off?
I think Google is also slowly moving towards this direction, but we started building this 2 years ago. Yeah.
So you're in front of them, you're in advance?
We believe that we are in a position to try something very quick and move faster than Google.
What do you need to do still before everybody is super happy about Remix OS and can use it instead of Microsoft?
I think we also need to push the whole ecosystem forward because all the apps need to support keyboard and mouse. And I think Google is doing a great job in this space when they launched Android N. Yeah.
Because, for example, right here we have Gmail, right? There's a big Google app. It's a very important Google app. But it's not optimized for keyboard and mouse.
For example, like if you right-click here, there's no menu, which I think Google will fix in Android N.
And you don't really need to have this kind of UI, but I guess maybe you do. But still, it needs to be better optimized for keyboard and mouse.
Correct. It could be better. Yeah.
And Chrome should be a full Chrome on Android. So it should be like the same Chrome as Chrome OS?
Correct. Yes, we believe that the browser can be much more powerful on these kind of chipsets, and you can have the full desktop experience.
And some other apps, like if we go in here, maybe we open YouTube.
If
you open YouTube, it doesn't really look like a desktop app.
I mean, they could do more, right?
Yeah, you can do more. Yeah, it's a mobile version of YouTube.
So how about the stuff that you have to do? I mean, this is what the developers have to do. They have to optimize all the apps for productivity. But what can you do to make it even better?
We actually do a lot to improve the whole system, like when you interact with the apps. Because a lot of the apps are optimized for mobile devices like cell phones, so we actually make the experience good on this device. For example, we are forcing some apps to launch in landscape mode instead of we have to force like rotate the screen.
So do you have a database of like that kind of identifies all the apps and says this one launch it like that, the other one launch it like this?
We actually try to do it in a more scalable way. We actually modify the framework a little bit so that most of the apps can be compatible on this device and this kind of form factor.
But there was some kind of leak or release of Android M that was kind of like pointing towards multi-window, right?
Yes, correct. But actually, Google implemented the multi-window, but a lot of the apps are still incompatible in Android M. So the app developers also need to fix those. But we actually try to fix something for the app developers.
So when we go in here and we check all the apps, there's Google Play Store right here. So has there been any changes in how Google is like telling you to do stuff with their apps?
So I think it's depending on the OEMs to actually formally apply for the Google Play on the device.
What do they need to have to be allowed to?
They have to pass the CTS. They have to formally get the consensus of Google to launch a device with this.
Remix OS definitely can pass CTS, right?
We have partner devices that pass CTS and also get GMS.
So Remix Mini has CTS?
Remix Mini has CTS.
And
we have also have other partner devices that formally have GMS.
So what's the status with partner devices? Are you going a lot to Shenzhen?
Yes, we are working with a lot of OEMs in Shenzhen and launching devices in different parts of the world.
And All-in-one A64 super stable. That's Remix Mini, right?
Yeah, correct.
And now AmLogic S905 is also, is it perfect now?
Yes, we support AmLogic S905. We support several chipset of All-in-one, Rockchip, MTK, Qualcomm.
How's it going with Qualcomm?
We have a device which we are launching with Qualcomm.
Did you launch it yet?
It's not formally launched yet, but it will be soon.
So it's going to be awesome?
Yeah.
It's going to be powerful?
It's going to be really powerful.
So this is a quad-core A53, which kind of like, it could be low performance, maybe kind of, but what's the performance of Remix OS on a quad A53 compared to like an Intel or something else? How's the performance different?
The performance is actually pretty good, especially for video and encoding stuff. As you can see, if you move the windows around, it's actually quite smooth, and you can play videos. You can play several videos at the same time without problem. Yeah. That's, I think, is the power of ARM chipsets. You don't need very powerful chipsets, but because of the lightweight of Android apps, you can actually do a lot with not that much power.
Is there one of the challenges that you have every time you port to a new CPU to support videos in the Chrome browser, so it plays smoothly inside the Chrome? Is it something you do, or?
It's not something we do, because I think natively Android already supports that. For the video playing in Chrome browser, a lot of the browsers already support HDMI5, which is natively supported in Android.
So everything is hardware accelerated in Android by default?
Yes, by default.
So there's not so much you need to do to optimize for hardware, like GPU doing something?
Sometimes, for example, when we move the windows around, we need to do some kind of power acceleration, but most of the heavy lifting work are already done by the chipset companies.
So it's free, and AOC is not paying you anything?
No.
It's just free?
We view it as a partnership. We want to promote Remix OS together, and we think that this will bring a lot of value to the users.
So, can you reassure us that your business model is not to spy on everybody?
No.
What is the business model?
We think that through this OS, we can actually work with the game companies to maybe promote some of the games to the users, and in that way we can also profit from some of the profit sharing.
Nice.
It's the same as like Google Play.
So basically you might have an app that might be pre-installed somewhere here that would be your account, like your store.
It would be your way to make money. It's not really a store, but it would be kind of like a promotion or like editor's choice kind of. Yeah.
Pre-installed apps, something like that.
Pre-installed apps or promotion apps.
Yeah. On your website or some other things?
On our website, yeah.
So how soon are you going to have 20 million or 50 million users or 100?
We hope with our partners like this, we are going to reach that number very soon.
Can you reach it before the end of this year? Are you going to be huge? You see a potential huge growth?
We are seeing a potential huge growth with partner devices coming out, more and more partner devices coming
so
out.
So how many guys are you at Remix team?
We have about 150 people.
150?
Yes.
In Beijing?
In Beijing.
Also a bunch in Shenzhen or?
We have a branch office in Shenzhen, but the majority and headquarters is in Beijing.
150 people, that's huge. It's bigger than the Google Android team. I'm joking, but it's quite, I mean, it's like you can really do stuff very fast.
Yes, yes. We have a huge R&D team, and then we have hardware team, software, business development, HR.
So there's some powerful guys that are supporting you, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah? And there's a competitor in Beijing also, right? The Phoenix. What do you say about that?
I think it's good that we are seeing other people doing this, but we focus on the product and we want to build the best Android experience.
So this is the future of Android. That's what I usually say when I film the Remix. I think this should what the future of Android should be, is to get into being more usable than just a smartphone and a tablet.
Correct. We believe Android can be used everywhere, on large screens, with keyboard and mouse, and in all sorts of devices, including TV, monitors, all-in-ones.
This is what we should have seen at the Microsoft keynote. But they're not getting it. You're getting it. All right, that's cool.